questions?
Well, of course, I can start a whole exposé about how good the relations between the Netherlands and the rest of the world are. But if you have any specific questions about it, I'll be welcome to answer that.
Can we ask you about North Korea?
Yes.
There seems to be a slight problem at the moment. This summit is now less than a month away. Do you think
yes.
it will go ahead? How worried are you?
I sincerely hope that it will go ahead. When I heard the first signals that there might be a summit between the presidents Trump and Kim, my reaction was I sincerely hope that this time it will lead to a lasting peace process, because we have seen startups of these kinds of processes over the past decades for a number of times, and those have been rather bumpy road, so I hope this will only be a bump on the road and not the end of the road.
I have a question on Gaza.
Yes.
There's a report that a senior Hamas official has said that approximately 50 of those killed on Monday in Gaza were members of Hamas. So I wonder if you had any comment on that, because the conventional wisdom has been that many of the victims.
Well, first of all, I'm of course shocked by the pictures that I have seen of the enormous violence that has been taking place. And I call upon both parties involved, both from the Israeli side and from the Palestinian side, to stop speaking out loudly, and instead of this, to start again negotiating like any responsible government should. With regard to what exactly happened, I think it is extremely important that if a nation uses violence, and there can be a need to use violence, I've used to be a security and justice minister myself, so I know it may be necessary to use violence. But if a country uses violence, you should investigate thoroughly, publish openly your findings, and if any faults have been made, you should also be clear about it and punish those responsible. So I'm waiting for a thorough investigation by the Israeli government.
On Iran, tomorrow you are going to Washington,
D.C.? Yes.
Tomorrow also, the EU will begin the process to block the consequences of the sanction.
Well, as you know, the Dutch government, together with our other European allies, regrets the decision taken by the Trump government about the Iran deal. And I will discuss with my colleague, Secretary of State Pompeo, tomorrow how it will be possible to protect Dutch and European companies from the consequences of this. As you may know, Netherlands is the third largest investor in the USA, contributing more than 700,000 jobs to the US economy. We have a very long-standing relation. Actually, the Netherlands was more than two centuries ago the first country to recognize the newly independent United States of America. So building on this very long tradition of friendship, I hope we can agree on a position where European and Dutch companies won't be suffering from the end of the Iran deal, the end as far as at least as the U.S. government is concerned.
Are you looking to have some exception, and are you going to see Mr. Bolton too?
I will be having an appointment with Mr. Bolton too, and indeed, now this decision has been taken, I think the best option for the European and Dutch companies would be an exemption.
Yes. How would you describe relations right now, as you're about to go into this meeting with Secretary of State Pompeo, how would you describe relations between the EU and the US at this stage, particularly given the comments of President Tusk, who said,
I do realize that those relations have become more complicated than in the past because of the decision, of course, on the Iran deal, The possible tariffs on steel and aluminium, the climate agreement, but all this against the background of a very long-standing relationship. I just described the very long-standing relationship between Netherlands and the USA, but also the fact that there has been peace and stability in Europe for over 70 years now is based on the fact that we have a very strong tie within NATO and, of course, both as members of the free world, believing in the rule of law, democracy, the market economy, that even in those somewhat difficult times, there is much more that binds us than that holds us apart. So I'm here in this difficult time to build bridges instead of to burn bridges. Of course, I am convinced that the population has the right to protest against any government. I think people protesting against my policies being a minister in the Netherlands. They should be free to do so, and they should not be confronted by violence. And as I just described about the violence on the Israeli-Gaza border, here again, a responsible government should, if the need of the use of violence is deemed necessary, always investigate thoroughly what happened, and if mistakes have been made, hold those responsible to account.
Final question.
In Burundi today, there's a referendum to put Pierre Nkurunziza in power until 2034, and I'm wondering, if people have been told if they abstain, they can go to jail. Does the Netherlands think that the council has done enough to try to make sure that election is free and fair, and what should be done going forward?
Well, of course, we should follow thoroughly what will happen during the election, whether it will be free and fair. If not, we should speak out clearly. Generally speaking, heads of government should be wise and know when it's time to go.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.